The thing hand to mouth. Why I stand to put nothing aside for my dog pitch.
Welcome back to Blood and Wine. I'm still not quite ready to get on the main quest yet. I'm one of those people that, when I see a question mark in Skyrim or Fallout or whatever, OCD compels it. Just can't be helped. There's actually a contract that I'm going to make my way to.
That Gwent will be the end of me. I've lost the game.
Giddy up.
We'll probably go win that Gwent tournament too before we start in on things. I actually don't think I really need money anymore. Except, yeah, I do. I gotta buy if I wanna bring all the Witcher sets into my New Game Plus save, then I probably need to blow all my money. Imagine living in a land where witchers just came in and stole all your food on a whim. Wonder how many people Geralt's caused to starve to death in his days. Florence. That was hardly worth the trouble. Let's see. You know, I do all this exploring at night for potion reasons, but probably should just bite the bullet and do it in day, because it's such an amazing map.
us in order!
Hang on, milady.
You, Jacob?
Heel, Moholt. Down. Who asks?
A witcher. Saw your notice.
Hold up. A witcher, you say? Like in Luis Herrera's Tales and Fables. Luckier than a green, bleeding leprechaun I am. See? Not a soul around believes this tree is Daphne, the cursed lady of legend. But you, you could lift the curse.
Bit too old to believe in bedtime stories, aren't you?
Want your chops busted, Witcher? How old I am, that is none of your porking concern.
Fair point. Not my business what you believe, either.
Ha! Huh. I'm content we see eye to eye.
Guy's got a pet wolf. That's pretty badass. He's a Stark.
So what makes you think there's a girl cursed inside the tree?
Well, I came out with my dog, Moholt, to cut her down. Axe in hand, a broad swing I took. The edge burrowed deep in her trunk. And bum botch me if blood didn't spurt forth. My jaw dropped in the dirt. But right then I knew, every jot of it in the tale of Daphne, Gareth, and the Witch of Lynx, Craig.
Don't tell me. From Herrera's Tales and Fables.
You porking bet. Second edition. Amended in octavo. I know those tales by heart. My nan read them to put me to sleep.
Guess she read it cover to cover, colophon included. Let me take a look at the tree.
Careful now. Stay with me.
Swear I hear sobs in the rustling leaves.
Maybe the guy's not nuts.
Seep from the direction of the tree, judging by the shape of the stain pool. Actually does bleed. Looks like human blood too. And the bark. Resembles hypertrophic scars in places. Medallions humming like crazy. Intense magic at work here.
Well, we got a good old-fashioned curse to lift.
Logger was making good time. Strange, though. Willows isolated. No other trees near it.
Our one on Fyke Isle didn't turn out too well.
And? Did you look at the tree close?
Mm-hmm. Actually does bleed. Pretty incredible. Looks wondrous.
Did I not say so?
My help doesn't come free, you know.
You speak to a lowly woodcutter. No stench of coin about me.
Yeah, I'll cut this guy a break.
Agreed. I will pay as soon as the young mate is free.
Willing to help, but first I gotta figure out where to start.
No need. I know it all. Miss Daphne and Sir Gareth shared a terrible and fearsome love for each other. Yet to prove himself worthy of her hint, Gareth was to face the Witch of Lynx Crag. Before Sir Gareth set off for the hill, Miss Daphne gave him her kerchief, a token of her favor.
Let me guess, he never returned.
He did not. She stood here day upon day, night upon night, trying to spy him.
Till she sprouted roots and turned into a tree? Wonder why?
I will fecking tell you why. To await the moment when Gareth returns, kerchief in hand. That is the power of love. The power of longing. So you must scale Lynx Crag. Search there for a means to free Daphne. I will give you my book of tales to refer to. And good luck, Witcher.
I'm gonna save this one. Where's this at? Too far. Yeah, we're making our way back to town, it looks like. Gonna hit up all these, three or four question marks on the way back. That was close. No, I don't want to lose that. Gotta refill after that. Came within an inch of dying like three times that fight.
My brother gave me a sword. I named it Need. I don't get paid to chit chat. Greetings.
Thank you. It's like an arena or something.
Mom? Where are ya?
You know, Death March would actually be kind of hard if I didn't put the 3 points into acquired tolerance.
Let's go!
No! God, you idiot, Roach. Get my ass kicked here. Hide him, get a better spot. You can just kill one of them.
Damn it.
God, did they dumb down Roach's AI further in this expansion? He's a fucking death trap. Thank you. Forgot the Erd works on me as well. I didn't have a problem with any of the Leshens in the base game, but I don't know if any of you remember the, there's one almost at the farthest east you can go from Oxenfurt where he summons like a pack of like 30, 40 wolves that just destroy you.
Coming down with a fever.
So it's not the Leshen that kills you, but the pack of, and they're over-leveled, too. They're like level, you know, 30 wolves when you're about 20, low to mid-20s then. Paranoia save here. Just in case. Damn it, more. What a difference the oil makes. Now what the hell am I fighting? I don't even know what's attacking me. Hell. that Geralt is going to have one hell of a wine cellar from his adventures here. Where's the treasure? Oh, there. Just there.
Geralt of Rivia, we are your debtors eternal.
Why didn't those guys pick all that loot up? I'd pick up 300 crowns if I slept them around. One more. I just wish they made Roach a little more like a Skyrim horse, you know, climbing 90 degree inclines and whatnot. Climbing throat of the world on your horse. Fucking hell, damn it. Yeah. Oh, great. Oh, I forget. That's why I'm getting raped by these guys, is I don't have vapor armor anymore. I was wondering why the poison was destroying me so bad. There you go. For a nation with no war, Toussaint has an exorbitant amount of abandoned villages.
Mouth dry as a stockfish.
Weird to kiss the ground.
Why do you stick on?
Back to camp. Or town. Not where I meant to go. Oops, they marked the wrong quest. That's what I was looking for.
To win the tourney with your name on my lips.
But what if another knight proves victorious? Many a valiant man has entered the list this year.
If it be so, then I pledge to remain silent.
Yeah, we may as well talk to this poor guy who's been waiting in the hospital for
not remove my health
3 weeks now.
I fulfill my first pledge to you next week.
Master Witcher, over here.
If I got any crafts, so.
Armor chromed, engraved or fluted, whatever your heart's desire.
Let's see what you got in stock.
Nothing to sell. Wait, armor kits. I never use them.
So long.
Here, Master Witcher. Over here.
Richard, I have a matter of prime urgency and import. I must speak to you.
Your wound. Feeling better?
It's healing splendidly, though I am to avoid trouble for some time. To be frank, that is precisely why I wish to speak with you.
Want me to stand in for you? Take on some trouble on your behalf?
That could very well be the case. You see, there is a maiden, nay, a lady. I suspect someone's cast an ill spell upon her. A curse, perhaps.
Let me guess. She suddenly grew cold, haughty, and distant, though the night before she was flirtatious and alluring.
Tut-tut, Witcher. You jest, yet the matter is grave. Though true, the lady in question is dear to my heart. I shall not deny it. I fear she has fallen victim to ill magic, and knows no one she could turn to for help.
What makes you think she might be cursed?
You must keep all I say to yourself, I beg you. I would never dare to be so indiscreet normally, yet I'm troubled about her, for her. Vivienne shuns the company of others. Though the fairest maid at court, she keeps men at a distance. I thus determined I would resort to trickery.
Trickery? That even befitting of a knight?
In war, yes. And what is love if not battle? As it were, one evening I crouched in hiding outside her seamstress's home. As Vivienne emerged from it, I too emerged, ever so gently but convincingly collided with her, then promptly offered to escort her home. She consented. At first, all augured well. I proposed a more scenic route. She agreed. I made kindly forays into conversation, and she even began to respond as we neared the end of our route.
Then suddenly,
mid-speech, from her mouth there flew a most hideous shriek. I stopped stone cold in my tracks while she turned red, then promptly ran off. I did not give chase that time. I attempted to approach her on several ensuing occasions, to learn what had happened, for I feared she had become entangled in some trouble. I noted that often, come night, she ventures into the woods, where I've seen her walk about a glade near a pool. I've striven on occasion to follow her, but lost track each time. It seemed then she'd melted into the air.
Notice any other strange behavior? Additional symptoms?
No, Vivienne's avoided me wholly since the first encounter.
Sounds like a bruxa.
What about?
They say she's secretive, that no one ever sees her after dusk, that she's wont to suddenly disappear.
Nothing unusual about any of that. Sound you heard. She might have just had a sore throat.
Had I thought it possible the sound was natural, I never would have taken up your precious time.
Tell me more about Vivienne. Who is she? What's her story?
She's Her Enlightened Highness's lady-in-waiting. Her mother was a lady-in-waiting, her father a knight. That is all I've learnt, for the Duchessa grows angry when asked about her. Vivienne spends her days within the palace walls. Yet we are in luck, for she has been named the tourney's patroness this year. Thus, each participant will be granted an audience with her.
Got a problem then. See, I'm not a participant.
I've devised a solution already. You shall take my place in the lists and thus gain the chance to speak to her. I was looking forward to winning the tourney, very much so. Yet for Vivienne, I am prepared to sacrifice anything.
You weren't gonna win. Trust me.
This tourney, how's it work exactly?
It is the year's grandest and most important contest. Knights from all corners come to face off for the grand prize. And more importantly, for glory. A demanding test of knightly prowess in horsemanship, marksmanship, and fencing. I qualified for the first time, had great hopes of winning. Yet...
Yeah, I get it. Anything for Vivienne.
I'm not going to haggle with him.
Fine, I'll look into it. Gotta admit, piqued my curiosity.
I shall be forever in your debt. Now, we must ensure you are not eliminated from the tourney before you can meet Vivienne.
Meaning?
Could you show me how you shoot, ride, and fight, perchance? And you must learn the tourney rules, know how to apply them in practice. I did not mean to suggest I doubt your abilities. Everyone must train, even a witcher. Besides, the tourney contests must surely differ, require skills you don't usually apply, races above all. The choice is yours. Where shall we start?
I'm gonna have to...
Apply all the skills you mentioned on a daily basis, and against monsters, not targets and dummies. Don't need any training. Going straight to the tourney grounds to sign up.
Now you must go to the inscription that honor and glory are all true and good, but your scrolls must...